Hi, this is Aisha. Let's continue chapter number 6, ICT applications. In this video, we will discuss about data handling application and measurement application. For complete subtopics, you can go to playlist of ICT applications. Let's start with data handling application. How the data is being handled by use of ICT. Data tracking, data mining and data analysis are some of the most important tasks that most organizations are required to do. Data analytics is a new science that analyzes large amount of raw data so that conclusion can be made for making decisions more accurately. For example, a large number of surveys conducted and you are just collecting all the information, you can draw the charts and you can see how about the results and you can make decisions accordingly. So what are the advantages of handling data with the use of ICT? Data can be updated, organized, sorted and searched in different ways. Data can be displayed or printed in different formats like query format, report format, forms. So it can be printed in different formats. Data can be backed up or moved using different storage media. Huge storage space not required. Just like filing cabinets, you do not need a room to store all the data. You just need a software and the devices to store all the data. So what are the different ways to collect the data? First of all, surveys. Data collection can be done using the surveys. Surveys are conducted using data capture forms. Previously, how surveys were conducted by just giving the hard copies to the clients. But that is difficult. Now, by the use of ICT, you can just share the link. They can fill the survey. Then you can collect all the data and based on graphs, you can decide. So before conducting this, you should decide what data needs to be collected. And then decide what questions should be there in the survey. That should be relevant to your requirement. Second way is address list. Organization that will deal with the mail orders needs address list or contact details of the customer. So for this, you can even use mobile phones to store all these things, or you can even use any software to store your phone numbers, your email addresses, name, and all the related data. Third, club and society records. Club and societies need to keep data of their members. It includes contact details, membership information, payment information. So based on the type of the club and the society, you can do particular searches. For example, specific age group you can search, specific sports you can search. So depending upon your requirement, you can do any particular searches over here. Next is school libraries. So information on current books which are available to borrow and members of the libraries is recorded. A typical school library system would store the following information. This is not all, so more or less it can be, but these are the information generally most of the school library system have. So what is the information for the books? They need ID number, title, author, publisher and other details also. For the borrowers, their ID number, name, class, date of birth, fines to pay. There might be other columns also. And for the loans, what is the book ID, borrower ID, date borrowed, returned or not returned yet. So there can be many more other columns also, but basic columns are this. Next is school reports. A school would typically keep data on the student academic performance in a computerized database. This would allow the school to easily track how students were doing as the year progressed, as well as making the creation of printed reports very easy. So instead of doing it manually by hand, just collecting all the data, all the information is being stored in the database. So at the end, you can get a complete report. Okay, a report should contain student specific data about the name, the grade, their section, students' progress, their attendance, teachers' comments, and the date of the report. Okay, so this all can be managed by use of ICT very easily. Next topic is measurement applications. All about data handling application is over now. So now what about the measurement application? Use of ICT in measurement applications. Sensors can be used to measure the analog values. Sensor can measure the analog values like temperature. Values are converted to digital form by using analog to digital converter, ADC, analog to digital converter, so that computer can understand. values are then sent to the computer or the microprocessor for further actions to be taken. So, what are the steps? Sensor will collect the values, analog values, then convert to digital and send to microprocessor for further action. What are the reasons for using ICT in measurement instead of human being or manual ways? So, what are the reasons we are using ICT in measurement? First of all, precision, that is more accurate and more frequent. Reliable, can take measurement all the time. For example, you want to take measurement for the 24 hours, they can take it. Accuracy, measurements are taken at exact time. Human being can do the little bit difference of seconds, but machines or sensors can do it accurately at exact time. Non-interference, measurements can be taken without disturbance. Efficiency, data can be analyzed more easily and more quickly. So these are the main reasons we use ICT in measurement applications. In scientific experiments, there are many different scientific experiments that needs to be controlled by the processors, which can take measurement and then can make decision based on that measurement. Few examples are here. For example, temperature sensor can be used to measure the temperature of a chemicals, or can be used to measure the temperature of engine in the engineering workshop. Light sensor, it can be used in a biological experiment about the plant growth. Pressure sensor can be used in the chemical experiment. So there are a lot of other examples also. These are few examples. So how scientific experiment use ICT. Next is weather stations. Weather stations contains lots of sensors which are used to gather a variety of different data. Different instruments and different sensors are used here. For example, thermometer is used to measure the temperature. Humidity sensor is used to measure the amount of water in the air. Barometer is used to measure the air pressure. Anemometer is used to measure the wind speed. And wind vane is used to measure the wind direction. Rain gauge can be used to measure the amount of rainfall. So many devices, many instruments and sensors can be used to detect the weather. And these sensors would feed the data into the computer, which is then analyzed by the forecaster. Analyzed data can be used to make prediction about future weather also. Next is, what is the difference between analog data and the digital data? Analog data is a continuous values, while on the other hand, digital data is discrete values. Okay, analog is continuous values and digital data is discrete value. For example, I'm recording this video, my sound waves are analog. Computer cannot understand this. But with the help of microphone, I'm just sending it to the computer, and then through the help of ADC, analog to digital converter, it is converting it into the binary form so that computer can understand this. Okay, computer can understand only binary form. So my voice is analog, by converting to through ADC to binary form, computer can understand. And if you are able to hear this, so again you are hearing, these are the sound waves, these are analog, but computer cannot understand. So what computer will do, it will convert this digital signal to analog by using DAC, digital to analog converter. Now from us to computer, analog digital converter is required. From computer to us, digital to analog converter is required. Then it will be again converted back into analog form. Microprocessor use in pollution monitoring also, measuring the levels of pollution in the environment and reporting the levels over long time period. Levels of gases produced by vehicle can also be monitored by using sensors and then reports back to computer via analog to digital converter. Computer can be used to draw graphs to show levels, store the data, store the results for future predictions, and produce different type of information. So what is the use of microprocessor in hospital or ICU? Sensors can be attached to the body of the patient to monitor heartbeat, blood pressure, temperature. It can improve access to the clinical data of the patient also, reduce errors, because no human interaction over here, automatically they are detecting the values and sending to the computer. It ensures quality standards, monitor patient's vital signs, and provides support for the decision making. For example, blood pressure is low, or high, it can give the beep sound to do some necessary actions to be taken. That is all for topic 6.2 and 6.3 is covered. In the next video, we will cover the next topic of chapter number 6. Thank you very much for listening.